This one's cool right here. Like a DJ one? Like, I'm gonna get the DJ one.
Heavy shot, DJ, you got the chicken.
Here's one with a walker. Like, none of them work. Sugar Ray. Look. Wow, Lily. This is a good one, but it's not working. Here's what we got. Some things just really excite me for no good reason. I guess it's a lot of it's nostalgia when you see things like this. Caddyshack, classic. One of the best movies of all time. But these little hamster guys, I kind of remember these. These are from 2000s, early 2000s. Yeah, maybe some of them came out. I think they're different years on some of these. 2002 is what I'm seeing on a lot of them. 2001. But maybe these came out. I think these came out maybe some of the late 90s, but definitely early 2000s. I picked up four of these guys. I looked some of them up. Some of these have good value, or I say decent value. None of them are like home runs, but decent value. That one right there is so cool. And I just want to keep them. I picked out the ones that I kind of liked because I didn't feel like looking all of them up. They were $3 a piece. None of these guys worked, which is unfortunate. I mean, their batteries are just dead, right? They're almost 20 years old. I did remove the Caddyshack one because I wanted to see. So I removed it. I just kind of cut these things. There's still the little plastic things in there. I don't know what else to do. I think if I'm going to keep them or sell them, I'd rather them work than just be like new attached. I don't know. But I put batteries in it, but the batteries I think are dying, so they probably need to be replaced because this sounds pretty sad. And they're supposed to move. They're all supposed to move and do something. Like, I think this guy twirls that around. So pretty cool, $3 a piece. Spent way too much time talking about those. But I'll probably end up selling them all. And then I got this brand new, like a little golf bag, like a little travel golf bag, $5. I looked it up, so maybe I get $20 for this. But I had a couple of, I think these are new, brand new Titleist golf balls. Haven't looked those up. You know, Titleist is a good brand. I might have, some of a low end, $10 for those two. So, and I just really like this bag. I felt like buying something. So that's what I got. Not a whole lot of value, but it's something. I'm gonna do a real quick video. I picked up a couple things out of Stevens. There you go. There it is. It's back behind me. Didn't do any video in the store. I wasn't sure if I was gonna buy this stuff, but I did. Cause I only scanned it. This is pretty cool though. Mario DVD, 5 episodes of something, but it's from 1990. So that's really cool. I scanned it and saw one listed for like $20, and I didn't do anything more than that. I mean, I probably could have searched the name and found some things, but $1, so I bought that. And then I wasn't gonna buy this until I realized that everything was $1, and then I got Call of Duty Black Ops 3 on the Xbox 360. Not complete, doesn't have the manual, but it's in, the disc is in really clean condition. So just a couple of things I picked up.
All right, so you saw those DVDs, Blu-rays that I got. Well, you saw that I had them. I did get them. So I got these two. They're 4K Hunger Games in good condition. They still have the little sticker things on there. So DVDs, discs, anything with a disc, Blu-rays, DVDs, 4K DVDs, are all $1.50. So I got those. And then I went ahead and, you didn't see this on camera, but I looked this guy up after the fact. And this is one of those that is actually a pretty good one to get. So it's complete. It has a little, I might put it in a nicer case, replace it with another DVD case. Just has a little bit of wear on the case, some dents, but everything is there. And this guy goes for about $20. So I think it's maybe a lot up situation with these two. These are probably $20-$25 together. This is $20. I spent about $5 for $40. So, you know, not a home run, but I found something better than nothing.
All right, so I'm at an antique mall. I've been here before, but it's been a couple of months. Let's see if they got anything good.
I just picked one of these up for next to nothing, and they're not going for anything. Wow.
Just some advice. Don't buy these. Tom Clark Jones. See how much I have them for here? They don't sell. I bought a ton of these guys and had to hold them forever. I had to eventually end up locking them up to get rid of them. Okay. This is a super cool one.
That's cool. They got some really cool launch boxes. And they have this one, which is from the 80s. And it's clean, super clean. With a thermos. For $19. I think I'm gonna get it. Nope. I don't know what it is with me and lunch boxes recently. I might get that if it was just the color was a little bit better. It's not bad, but still. And I almost missed that. Okay. I feel like I got to do it. Don't know. More lunchbox stuff. What did I tell you? Holy no. This reminds me, I got a lot of Fiesta where I need to sell. Does anybody else know about this stuff?
Quick show and tell of what I got.
Nothing for resale, everything was for me. Roger Rabbit, pretty cool, from 1987. Clean graphics, just clean all around, except for some dirt. Thermos is there. This was about $18, I think you saw that earlier, so that's cool. And this is out of a lunchbox, G.I. Joe. 1987. There's the Defiant Shuttle. There's the Mamba. All right, it's getting dark, but I'm gonna try to do a recap of what we just bought. you can see, I think you can see, $9 I paid for everything. Rounded up. Couple of plush. Mickey, 2017. I wasn't gonna get him at first when I searched Mickey plush 2017, and then I went to Solds and there's just happened to see him. This exact same one sold for like $30, so picked him up. Picked up a vintage Paddington bear. I see these quite often. I just sold one the other day, a smaller one. This is a little bit bigger. So he's from the 70s, I guess maybe new, but his little tag is torn there. You know, for like a dollar, I can't help myself. I gotta pick stuff up like that. And then the same thing here, like just brand new media, 15 CDR Sony sealed, $2. I can't pass it up. I just can't pass it up. And then again, another thing I just can't pass up, some polo khakis pants, brand new with tags. Anything with polo, if it's new, almost instantly pick it up if it's $4 or less. So these were $4. You can see what they go for, the MSRP. I think you can see it there. I didn't actually look these up. They're called Andrew. Andrew pant, that's what they're called. I looked it up just to make sure, even though I was gonna buy them probably either way. Usually I don't look up anything new polo. But I looked them up and I think maybe I can get 35 bucks for them. So pretty good score overall. I had to dig for this stuff. Wasn't expecting much, but I still found some things. So that's great. Okay, it's getting dark, but I just wanted to go over the items that I got at the last thrift store. And today has ended up being a DVD day, I guess. So this is interesting. Anything, I just looked up stuff. I don't have no idea about this, but this is interesting. So that sells for $15 to $20 plus shipping. This right here, this is new sealed. You know, even use it sells for like $15, $20. I think I can get $20 to $30 on that. VHS. I didn't look this up. It doesn't go for much, even though it's sealed. I have a theory on VHS. So when I find them cheap enough, I pick them up. If they're not worth selling now, I'm going to keep them. My theory is that sometime in the hopefully not so distant future, VHS will start to go back up and they'll be worth something. Picked up a pair of Levi's 550 vintage, and I know they're vintage because they are made in the USA, and these are women's. Pretty good size for women's because of the style. I think when I looked it up, they call them like mom jeans because they're kind of oversized, so they're kind of in style. I think maybe I can get low end 20, the high end 30 to 40, maybe. So that's pretty good. I think those were like $5. And this is a somewhat vintage polo sweater. It's like an argyle pattern, which is like this cross pattern. It is cotton and cashmere, and it's a great size, 2XLT. Condition looks okay. Like, I didn't notice any flaws. Now, I'm gonna have to pay a little bit more attention to it before I list it, but it looked pretty good. And these, you know, I don't know, because when you do comps, sometimes it's hard to find comps on some of this stuff, but at least 30, but I might be able to shoot on the high side because of the size. And it's actually a really pretty pattern, pretty color. So I think that was $4. So let's just, you know, 30, 20, 20, nothing, 20. So still pretty good little haul. Appreciate the views. Until next time.